press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, some important concept oriented questions and previous entrance point of view questions. Now I would like to discuss, and the topic name is the S block elements. And here some questions, especially for S block elements, we expect minimum one question for NEET and one question for JEE. JEE possibilities are less, but NEET compulsory one question we will expect for S block elements. So here, from that questions, question number one, simple question. This is: during the electrolysis of fused NaCl, the reaction at anode. So fused NaCl is nothing but liquid NaCl. Liquid NaCl means NaCl plus water gives rise to NaCl. This is said to be aqueous NaCl. Aqueous NaCl means addition of water to sodium chloride. We will get that the compound is called as aqueous. And second point is NaCl on heating, then it becomes melt. This portion is called as fused NaCl, melting of NaCl, then we will get fused NaCl. And this fused NaCl on electrolysis, already we know two electrodes only be required. One is a cathode, second one is the anode. So here, during electrolysis, cathode and second one is a anode. So which reactions takes place with respect to the electrodes, means you should remember, this is very very important point. Anode, the pronunciation is anode. Anode is oxidation, while cathode is reduction. Anode oxidation while cathode is reduction. So what is oxidation? Loss of electrons. What is reduction? Gain of electrons. Loss of electrons oxidation, gain of electrons reduction. Which species undergoes lose electrons and gain electrons? Means negative species are electron losers, positive species are electron acceptors. So remember this point: positive species electron acceptors, negative species electron losers. Clear it is? Positive species electron acceptors, negative species electron losers. Depends upon that NaCl ionizes Na plus plus Cl minus. This is a ionization reaction. From this, 2 NaCl gives rise to 2 Na plus plus 2 Cl minus, and Cl minus negative species, sodium positive species. From the question, anode means oxidation. Oxidation is loss of electrons. Loss of electrons which are undergoes negative species. So 2 Cl minus, lose how many electrons? 2 electrons, and liberate which gas? Chlorine gas. This was the information regarding the question. Clear? So once you cross check that options, option 1, Cl minus ions are oxidized. Cl minus ions are what it is? Oxidized during the electrolysis of fused NaCl. So you should remember these points for entrance point of view. Anode oxidation, cathode reduction. What is oxidation? Loss of electrons. Reduction is gain of electrons. So option number 1 is the right answer for the question number 1. And next, followed by question number 2. Question number 2, this is a diagonal relationship. Lithium shows diagonal relationship with which element? So simple it is, already we know that lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon. These are second period elements. After that, sodium, magnesium, aluminium, silicon. These are third period elements. Diagonal relationship, we know that second period first element and third period next group next element. So if you select second period lithium and third period is next group is beryllium, next group next element is what? Magnesium. So the properties is in between lithium versus magnesium are similar due to the same in size, due to the same electronegativity values. These elements are undergoes diagonal relationship. Diagonal relationship means what the properties we found regarding this is similar. And while coming to the next one, beryllium diagonal relationship with what it is? Aluminium. Clear it is. Lithium shows diagonal relationship with only the magnesium. If the question was beryllium, then the answer is aluminium. So, first option is right for the question number 2. And next, followed by the question number 4. Question number 4, very very important it is. This type of questions we expect for entrance. Question number 4. Which of the following carbonates decomposes readily at low temperatures? Which of the following carbonates decomposes means here two types of carbonates will be there. M2CO3, MCO3. M2CO3 are first A group elements, carbonates. Example, Li2CO3, Na2CO3. K2CO3, RB2CO3, CS2CO3. Lithium carbonate, sodium carbonate, potassium carbonate, rubidium carbonate and cesium carbonate. While coming to the second one, BeCO3, beryllium carbonate, magnesium carbonate, calcium carbonate, strontium carbonate, barium carbonate. These are said to be alkaline earth metals, metal carbonates. So here these are unstable means these carbonates are readily decompose. Alkaline metal carbonates, first A group metal carbonates are most stable. These are not undergoes decomposition, except one example is there, that is lithium. Lithium carbonate only undergoes decomposition. Rest of all carbonates are not undergoes decomposition. What happens when lithium carbonate undergoes decomposition? It gives rise to Li2O plus CO2. Li2O is called as lithium monoxide. Lithium form monoxide, we know that. Sodium form peroxide. Remaining all are form superoxides. Except lithium, remaining all carbonates of first A group elements not ready to decompose. All are stable carbonates. All are stable carbonates. Lithium carbonate is unstable. This will be the anomalous behavior of lithium. First group, in any group, first element, the properties was anomalous, quite different with respect to the rest of the elements. That is expressed in the form of anomalous behavior of first element. So, lithium carbonate on decomposed gives rise to lithium monoxide plus carbon dioxide. So, answer for this question is third option is right answer. Remaining all carbonates are not decomposes. Remaining all carbonates are not decomposes. So third one is the right option for this question. And next followed by the question number 7, very very important it is. A hydrated solid X on heating initially gives a monohydrated compound Y. Y upon heating above 373 Kelvin leads to an anhydrous white powder Z. X and Z respectively what? So here hydrated solid X. What is X? According to our information, according to our synopsis, according to what we learned regarding this alkali metals, we know hydrated solid is one and only, that is Na2CO3 10H2O. Na2CO3 10H2O is called as sodium carbonate. It is also called as washing soda. This is washing soda. Washing soda is the correct example with respect to that passage, a hydrated solid X on heating. What the temperature here we require? 373 Kelvin temperature. On strongly heating, this initial reactant can lose 9 water molecules. 9 water molecules and formation of Na2CO3H2O. This is said to be sodium carbonate monohydrate. And if the temperature raises greater than 373 Kelvins, this one more water molecule also lost from sodium carbonate monohydrate and formation of Na2CO3. This is called as soda ash. We will get soda ash. So according to the options, the option 1 is baking soda is wrong. Option 2, baking soda wrong. Option 3, washing soda and dead burns plaster also wrong. Option 4 was, see that option 4, washing soda and soda ash. Compound 1 is washing soda. On strong heating, washing soda less than 373 Kelvins, it loses 9 water molecules and formation of monohydrate, sodium carbonate monohydrate. Later, if temperature raises more than 373, it loses one more water molecule to give rise to soda ash. So you should make a note regarding this question. You should write this equation, then you will get idea about this. Clear it is. So answer is the fourth option, washing soda and soda ash. And next one is Na2CO3 can be manufactured by solvays process, but K2CO3 cannot be prepared in a similar way because. Very, very important question this is. This question we expect for board examination as well as in competitive also we expect. So, in solvay process, we can use it to prepare Na2CO3. Na2CO3 can be manufactured by solvay process, but K2CO3 cannot be prepared in a similar way. What will be the reason? Means that this is one and only reason was there for this question. In that solvay process, we will get one intermediate. What about that intermediate? Means NaHCO3. NaHCO3 is called as sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate, it is actually, it is insoluble. Insoluble means we will get precipitation. Sodium bicarbonate, insoluble precipitation we will get while in that process. Which process? That is said to be solvays process. Solvays process, we will get, this was an intermediate. This was while reactions are going on at a particular stage. At a particular stage, we will get sodium bicarbonate. Sodium bicarbonate preparation, PBT we will get. On that PPT, you can separate that PPT and transfer into another test tube and dry the PPT and decompose the PPT. What happens when decompose the PPT? When decompose the PPT, we will get Na2CO3 plus CO2 plus H2O. So, we will get the compound. Actually, we required Na2CO3. We required Na2CO3. So, once the PPT takes place in this reaction, while that reaction steps, once we will get the PPT, you can separate the PPT and dry it and decompose, then we will get Na2CO3. Suppose instead of NaHCO3, same reactions takes place with respect to the potassium, we will get same similar compound, that is similar with NaHCO3, potassium hydrogen carbonate, or this is also called as potassium carbonate. It is also called as a potassium carbonate. And this potassium carbonate is soluble. Potassium carbonate is soluble. If this compound is soluble, means how can we separate PPT? If it is insoluble, then we will get separate that PPT, dry that PPT and decompose the PPT, we will get Na2CO3. And in the second, on the other hand, what you observed, instead of sodium hydrogen carbonate, if you consider potassium hydrogen carbonate, this potassium hydrogen carbonate is completely soluble in the solution. Completely soluble in the solution means from this only we will get potassium carbonate. So it is completely soluble in the solution. So how we can separate? There is no formation of PPT. If PPT is not formation, there is no decomposition. So Solvay process is not suitable to preparation of K2CO3. It is only suitable to Na2CO3 due to the solubilities of NaHCO3 and KHCO3. NaHCO3 insoluble in the solution. KHCO3 is soluble in the solution. If soluble means no PPT takes place. Insoluble, PPT takes place, we will get final product. So option number third, KHCO3 is more soluble than NaHCO3. That was the right answer for the question number 9. Next one, question number 12. When zinc is treated with excess of NaOH, the product is obtained what? Zinc is actually, we know that is amphoteric. Amphoteric means zinc and tin both are said to be amphoteric. Both are react with acids as well as bases. So what the products we will get? When zinc is treated with hydrochloric acid, liberate hydrogen. When zinc is treated with sodium hydroxide, to formation of the compound is called as sodium zincate. What the component is? Sodium zincate. Sodium zincate formula, already we know that the equation was, this was equation Zn plus 2NaOH gives rise to Na2ZnO2 plus H2O. This was the formula regarding that question. When zinc is treated with excess of sodium hydroxide, what will be the product? Product is not zinc hydroxide, not second option is wrong. First option, zinc hydroxide formula is right, but second option is completely wrong. And third one is the right answer. What is third one? That is Na2ZnO2. Na2ZnO2 means sodium zincate, that is called as sodium zincate. We will get excess. When the compound is excess, we will get sodium zincate. So the right answer for that question number 12 is what about that? Na2ZnO2. Third answer was right. Third option is right. So here we will get not H2O, liberate H2 here. So make correction. This is, they liberate H2. Na2ZnO2 plus liberate H2 gas. So make one correction. This one, clear it is. So the right answer is third one is a right option. And next one, order of reducing power of alkali metals is very, very important. This was one short and sweet line was there in your NCERT text. What will be the reducing power of alkali metals? Reducing power of alkaline earth metals, it was given, and the values also there in the text. According to the values, we have to differentiate which alkali metal was the strongest reducing agent and which alkali metal is the weakest reducing agent according to the SRP values. What are the SRP values? Means standard reduction potential values. Standard reduction potential values. So according to the SRP, so here SRP inversely proportional to reducing property. This was a relation. SRP inversely proportional to reducing property. What is SRP means? Standard reduction potentials. One tabular form was there in the NCERT text. Once you go through the NCERT text and once you observe that the tabular form, on the tabular form there was given SRP values. On that SRP values, some positive values was there and some negative values also there. Means with respect to the alkali metals, there is no negatives. So with respect to alkali metals, all are, there was given positive values. And on that they should given order also. What will be the order? reducing power of alkali metals in means lithium is the strongest reducing agent. It is lithium is the strongest reducing agent. On that group, sodium is the weak reducing agent. Only it is for alkali metals. Lithium is the strongest reducing agent and sodium is the weakest reducing agent. And is in between remaining elements are there potassium, rubidium, cesium. And so what will be the order regarding that means lithium, cesium, rubidium, potassium, sodium. This will be the order. So you have to revise this order. When once you revise, then you will get idea about this. SRP values. SRP means standard reduction potential values. Standard reduction potential values, according to that values only, we have to decide which one is the strongest reducing agent and which one is the weak reducing agent. So, the right option for this question number 13 is, fourth option is the right answer. After that, next one, this is a beyond NCERT question. Actually, this information was not there in your text, but sometimes we should revise beyond NCERT questions also, a little bit useful for entrance. CaCN2 plus C is called what? CaCN2 is called as a CaCN2 plus C. How we will get CaCN2 means calcium reacts with carbon gives rise to calcium carbide. These are the steps. Ca plus C gives rise to what? CaC2. CaC2 plus N gives rise to CaCN2. CaC2 plus N gives rise to what? CaCN2. So, we to avoid this, we should take this equation. CaC2 plus N. Calcium carbide. Calcium carbide is treated with nitrogen to gives rise to calcium cyanamide. This is called as calcium cyanamide. This is called as calcium cyanamide, and this calcium cyanamide is associated with C. C is one of the allotropic form of carbon. In this part, C is called as graphite. C is called as graphite. Plus CaCN2 is called as calcium cyanamide. Calcium cyanamide plus graphite. Calcium cyanamide plus graphite. This mixture is called as nitrolim. This mixture is called as nitrolim because of once hydrolysis of this reaction. Hydrolysis of this cyanamide, we will get the compound is ammonia, which can be used for further productions of fertilizers. Due to that, for the fertilizer industry, fertilizer in the fertilizer stream, we should use this calcium cyanamide. So, calcium cyanamide plus graphite. Calcium cyanamide plus graphite. Calcium cyanamide plus graphite is called as nitrolim, used as a fertilizer to production of ammoniated fertilizers. Because of hydrolysis of cyanamides, produce ammonia. This is a process is a cyanamide process, but now NCERT text this process was deleted. In previous it was there, but now NCERT only one process is there, that is Haber's process. So this is cyanamide process to preparation of ammonia. Calcium cyanamide plus graphite is called as nitrolim. So answer is third option is a right for that question. Clear? And next one. Question number 25th. The useful byproducts obtained in the Solvay process of manufacturing sodium carbonate. Which are the useful byproducts? What are the useful byproducts when we obtained in the Solvay process of manufacturing of sodium carbonates? That is quicklime, CO2, NHCO3, NH4Cl and NH4Cl solution and quicklime. And sodium bicarbonate and carbon dioxide. Sodium bicarbonate and carbon dioxide. So Salvay process is useful to the preparation of sodium bicarbonate, not for sodium carbonate, not for potassium carbonate. Already we discussed regarding potassium carbonate is not used to the preparation of for the Salvay process it is. So here what will be the answer for this question means in the Salvay process we will get the answer is ammonium chloride solution and quicklime. Ammonium chloride solution and quicklime both are said to be the byproducts because of NaCl, CO2 and NH3. NaCl, CO2, NH3. NaCl, CO2, NH3. What reaction takes place between these two means carbon dioxide gas is passing through that ammonia solution and it is said to be brine solution. Ammoniated brine, this is called as ammoniated brine. When these three are combines, we will get the compound. One is NaHCO3, sodium bicarbonate. Addition with sodium bicarbonate, this is already I said in previous question, that is this is the PPT, insoluble PPT. Along with insoluble PPT, we will get one more compound, that is NH4Cl. This is NH4Cl. When brine solution is treated with ammonia, clear? Brine solution is treated with ammonia plus carbon dioxide. We will get the compound is ammoniated. What about that? This is totally said to be ammoniated brine. Ammoniated brine produce sodium hydrogen carbonate, insoluble precipitation, and this is a byproduct. This byproduct is called as ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride. And one more point was there, while preparation of Salvay, while preparation of sodium carbonate in Salvay process, we can use one more compound, that is a limestone. What is limestone? Limestone is called as calcium carbonate. On decomposition of limestone, what we will get? We will get CaO plus CO2. Calcium oxide is called as quicklime. Calcium oxide is called as quicklime and CO2 is called as carbon dioxide. This carbon dioxide is utilized in this reaction, this step. The carbon dioxide evolved on decomposition of limestone. Limestone on decomposes liberated carbon dioxide gas. This carbon dioxide gas is used to ammoniated brine solution to produce sodium bicarbonate and ammonium chloride. And additional with what we will get here? Calcium oxide. Calcium oxide is obtained when decomposition of calcium carbonate. Ammonium chloride is obtained when NaCl treated with CO2 plus NH3. And one more reaction is there Salvay's process. These byproducts, calcium oxide plus ammonium chloride, are combined to produce again NH3 plus H2O plus CaCl2. See this. These products again are combined to produce NH3. This is a recyclic step. Recyclic step means this NH3 again used in step 2. This CO2 also used in step 2. So this will be the very important suitable process to the preparation of sodium carbonate in the name of Salvay's process. So some systematical equations are there in the Salvay process. You should go through NCERT, then you will get idea about that. Clear it is. So NH4Cl obtained from NaCl plus CO2 plus NH3. CaO is obtained from decomposition of CaCO3. Clear? And what the reactions takes place, what the products we expect, these products again reused in the reaction, cyclic reaction it is. So due to that, the right answer for this question is third option, you should go NH4Cl solution and quicklime. NH4Cl solution and quicklime is the right answer for this question number 25. And next, the chemical formula for certain pyrophosphate is Ca2P2O7, the formula of its ferric pyrophosphate will be pyrophosphate formula given. Pyrophosphate pyrophosphate which pyrophosphate Ca2P2O7 Ca2P2O7 actually it is H4P2O7 pyrophosphoric acid H4P2O7 is called as a pyrophosphoric acid. This is a pyrophosphoric acid. Removal of 4 hydrogens from that will get pyrophosphate. Pyrophosphate is P2O7 4 minus. P2O7 4 minus is said to be pyrophosphate. So calcium pyrophosphate Ca2P2O7, because of calcium 2 plus and P2O7 is 2 minus. P2O7 actually it was 4 minus because of in this example total 4 hydrogens takes place. Tetrabasic compound. And one more is there, we know that ferric. Ferric is Fe3 plus and ferrous is Fe2 plus. These are two important forms of iron. Iron is available in two forms. One is a ferrous, second one is ferric. Ferrous is Fe2 plus and ferric is Fe3 plus. And phosphorus is also, this is an example for oxyacid of phosphorus. Oxyacid of phosphorus, pyrophosphoric acid. And with respect to these two, we have to find the formula of ferric pyrophosphate. Ferric pyrophosphate. What will be the formula of ferric pyrophosphate? So ferric pyrophosphate. What is ferric? Ferric charge is Fe3 plus. Ferric charge is Fe3 plus. On other hand, pyrophosphate. What is pyrophosphate charge? Pyrophosphate charge is P2O7 4 minus. P2O7 4 minus. Crisscross process, already we know that crisscross method. On addition of that, what will get? Fe4 P2O7 taken thrice. Fe4 P2O7 taken thrice is a answer for ferric pyrophosphate. Fe4 P2O7 taken thrice, that is a third option was there in that sequence. Third option, Fe4 P2O7 taken thrice. The 3 number stands for ferric, this 4 number stands for pyrophosphate. On addition of that too, with respect to the crisscross method. So this will be the answer for the question number 27. Next one is, when washing soda is heated, washing soda formula, we know that Na2CO3 10H2O. When washing soda heated temperature less than 373 kelvins, it loses 9 water molecules, then we will get Na2CO3.H2O. Again heating strongly greater than 373 kelvin temperature, again it can lose one more water molecule and formation of what it is Na2CO3. This is called as soda ash. So options, once you observe the options, CO released, CO and O2 released, O2 released, nothing because of CO, CO2 cannot release because of alkali metal carbonates are stable carbonates. Alkali metal carbonates are stable metal carbonates. Due to that, they are not liberate carbon dioxide, not liberate carbon monoxide, not liberate oxygen. Only water will be liberated. 373, 9 water molecules liberated, followed by more than 373, one more water molecule liberated, we will get soda ash. So answer is only water liberated. Water liberated, that is water vapors is released. Option 4, see that. Option 4 is right answer for the question number 31. Option 4. Next. Question number 32, the sequence of ionic mobility in aqueous solution. This was very important, the sequence of ionic mobility in aqueous solution. This ionic mobility is completely related with the size of the ion, because Alar was given that alkali metal ions, and the smaller size, higher will be the hydration. Size increases, mobility increases. Mobility increases means less hydration. Smaller size, higher will be the hydration. See that. Smaller size, that is a higher will be the hydration. Smaller size, that is higher will be the hydration. Then size increases, mobility increases. Size increases, mobility increases, hydration enthalpy will be decreases. Enthalpy of hydration is decreases. Enthalpy of lattice increases. Already we done one question regarding this. Size is directly proportional to enthalpy of hydration. Enthalpy of hydration means inversely proportional, sorry. Size inversely proportional to enthalpy of hydration. Small size, more hydration. Less, large size, less hydration. So, small size, higher will be the hydration. Size increases, mobility increases. Size increases, mobility increases means according to the options, there was given sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium was given. Sodium small size, next potassium, next rubidium, next cesium. So, what will be the answer is, second option you should go, cesium greater than, rubidium greater than, potassium greater than, sodium. That was the right answer because of size increases. Size increases means mobility increases. Size increases is called as mobility increases. So, second option is right for the question number 32. Option number 2. Smaller size, higher will be the hydration. So, size increases, mobility also increases. Less hydration. And next one is question number 33. This is a direct textbook question. It is direct point was given, theory oriented. It is the raw materials in Solvay process, sodium chloride, NH3, CsCO3. So instead of that, sometimes they should give like this also. Sodium chloride we should written as a brine solution. Brine solution is nothing but 10% NaCl. 10% NaCl is called as brine solution. And second one is ammonia. And third one is limestone. What is limestone? Is CaCO3. Limestone is called as CaCO3. So these are the raw materials to the preparation of sodium carbonate. This is used in the, this is preparation of sodium carbonate. So sodium chloride is treated with ammonia, and decomposition of limestone liberates CO2. Already we done CO2 plus NH3 plus NaCl, we will get NHCO3 and NH4Cl, and NHCO3 on strong heating we will get Na2CO3. So this is also one of the important question for entrance. So you should revise this brine solution, ammonia, limestone. Fourth option is a right answer for the question number 33. And next, question number 37. Which of the following pairs can be distinguished by action of heat? Which of the following pairs can be distinguished by action of heat? So option 1 was given, Na2CO3 and CaCO3. CaCO3 on heating, CaO plus CO2. Na2CO3 on heating, no reaction. See this, because it is stable. Sodium carbonate is stable. Alkali metal carbonates are stable. Alkaline earth metal carbonates are decomposed. But alkaline metals carbonates are stable. In CO3 not decompose. CaCO3 decompose to liberate CaO and CO2. Liberate CO2 and formation of calcium oxide residue. It is called as residue. Clear? So these two can be distinguished. And option 2, MgCl to 6H2O and CaCl to 6H2O. MgCl to 6H2O plus and CaCl to 6H2O. On heating CaCl to 6H2O, here we take which reaction it is? Dehydration. Dehydration means removal of water takes place. Removal of water takes place. Same reaction you observed, you applied to MgCl to 6H2O. Then here, this magnesium chloride is not undergoes dehydration. Instead of dehydration, in this example, we will get chlorides. Which chlorides means magnesium chlorides. So, CaCl2 on heating, we will get dehydration. Dehydration means water molecules will be lost. Same technique you apply to this on heating magnesium chloride 6H2O. Instead of loss of water molecules, it can form a magnesium chloride. Magnesium chloride. So, these two compounds also distinguish takes place with respect to action of heat. And next option number 3 is there. Option number 3. Option number 3, calcium nitrate and sodium nitrate. Calcium nitrate on heating, what we will get? Calcium nitrate on heating gives rise to calcium oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen. Option 3, calcium nitrate. And sodium nitrate was there, option 3. Calcium nitrate on heating. CaNO3 taken twice on heating, we will get CaO plus NO2 plus O2 we will get. NO2 reddish brown color gas we will get, reddish brown vapors. On other hand, NaNO3. NaNO3 is called as sodium nitrate. Sodium nitrate on heating, we will get sodium nitrite plus oxygen. NaNO2 plus oxygen we will get. One is a reddish brown color vapors and second one is a colorless vapors, colorless gas. Colorless gas will be evolved and reddish brown gases are evolved means we have to easy to differentiate the three compounds. Compound 1, compound 2 and compound 3. Three compounds are differentiated with respect to the heat. See this, Na2CO3 not decompose, it is stable. CaCO3 decompose. Magnesium calcium chloride dehydrate, water molecules can be lost, but magnesium chloride cannot dehydrate. Magnesium chloride formation of magnesium chloride means hydrogen chloride will get, HCl, chloride of hydrogen it is. And third example, calcium nitrate decompose reddish brown vapors, sodium nitrate decompose oxygen liberate. In this example also oxygen, but here colorless gas, here color gas. So option 3, option 3, 1, 2 and 3, second option. Second option is the right answer for this question. 1, 2 and 3 can be distinguished on heating. Which is not correct for lithium? This type of questions are said to be passage type questions or content oriented questions. You should revise that content, then you will get idea about this. This question is completely related with anomalous behavior of lithium. Lithium is softer than that of other alkali metals. That is wrong statement, because lithium is harder than other alkali metals. Remaining all other alkali metals are very very soft, easy to cut with knife. That point only given in the text. Lithium is softer than that of other alkali metals is a completely wrong statement. And second, third, fourth statements once you observe, hydrated lithium ions is the largest among alkali metal hydrated ions. The melting points, boiling points of lithium are comparatively high and the ionization enthalpy and electronegativity of lithium higher than other alkali metals. These are exactly right regarding lithium. This total question is related with anomalous behavior of lithium. So, statement 1, what they was given, that is completely wrong statement. Lithium is not softer, lithium is harder than that of other alkali metals. So, question which is not correct for lithium means, first option is not correct for lithium. Lithium is harder than that of other alkali metals. In that question, they was given it is softer. So, ఆప్షన్ వన్ ఇస్ ద రైట్ ఫర్ క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 40 అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 42 క్వశ్చన్ నెంబర్ 42 వెరీ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ అమంగ్ ద ఫాలోయింగ్ ద పారామాగ్నెటిక్ కాంపౌండ్ ఇస్ ద పారామాగ్నెటిక్ కాంపౌండ్ ఇస్ సింపుల్ క్వశ్చన్ దిస్ ఇస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ ఇట్ ఇస్ NA2O2 సోడియం పెరాక్సైడ్ O3 ఓజోన్ N2O నైట్రస్ ఆక్సైడ్ లాఫింగ్ గ్యాస్ ఇట్ ఇస్ అండ్ KO2 పొటాషియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ పొటాషియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ వాట్ విల్ బి ద కండిషన్ ఫర్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ 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 మీన్స్ దట్ ఈస్ ఆడ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆన్ అదర్ హ్యాండ్ అన్పేర్డ్ డి ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ దిస్ ఈస్ అప్లైడ్ ఫర్ డి బ్లాక్ దిస్ సెకండ్ పాయింట్ ఈస్ అప్లైడ్ ఫర్ డి బ్లాక్ అన్పేర్డ్ డి ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఫస్ట్ పాయింట్ ఈస్ అప్లైడ్ ఫర్ ఎస్ బ్లాక్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఆడ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆడ్ నంబర్ వెన్ విల్ గెట్ ఆడ్ నంబర్ ఆడ్ నంబర్ వెన్ విల్ గెట్ మీన్స్ అకార్డింగ్ టు ద అటామిక్ నంబర్స్ వైల్ కమింగ్ టు ద ఓజోన్ ఆక్సిజన్ ఈస్ ఎయిత్ గ్రూప్ సిక్స్త్ గ్రూప్ ఎలిమెంట్ ఆక్సిజన్ అటామిక్ నంబర్ 8 8 స్టాండ్స్ ఫర్ 8 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ 8 × 3 24 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ 24 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఈవెన్ నంబర్ నైట్రోజన్ 7 7 2 14 14 ప్లస్ 8 22 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఈవెన్ నంబర్ నైట్రోజన్ 7 అటామిక్ నంబర్ 7 2 నైట్రోజన్స్ 7 × 2 14 ఆక్సిజన్ 8 14 ప్లస్ 8 22 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ సోడియం 11 11 × 2 22 ఆక్సిజన్ 8 18 × 2 16 16 ప్లస్ 22 ఇస్ 38 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ 38 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆల్సో ఈవెన్ నంబర్ అండ్ వెల్ కమింగ్ టు ద లాస్ట్ ఆప్షన్ KO2 పొటాషియం 19 అండ్ ఆక్సిజన్ 8 ప్లస్ 8 16 19 16 విల్ గెట్ 35 ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఈజ్ నథింగ్ బట్ డిఫరెంట్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ ఆడ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆడ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ డ్యూ టు దిస్ రీజన్ పొటాషియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ రుబీడియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ సీజియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ ఆల్ సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ ఆర్ కలర్డ్ ఆల్ సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ ఆర్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ డ్యూ టు ద ప్రెజెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆడ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ పొటాషియం రుబీడియం సీజియం ఫామ్ సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ సోడియం ఫామ్ పెరాక్సైడ్ లిథియం ఫామ్ ఓన్లీ మోనాక్సైడ్ దిస్ విల్ బి ద ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ రిగార్డింగ్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ లిథియం ఫామ్ మోనాక్సైడ్ సోడియం ఫామ్ పెరాక్సైడ్ పొటాషియం రుబీడియం సీజియం ఆర్ ఫామ్ సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ ఆల్ సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ ఆర్ కలర్ఫుల్ అండ్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ సబ్స్టెన్సెస్ హౌ టు ఎక్స్ప్రెస్ ద పారామాగ్నెటిక్ బిహేవియర్ మీన్స్ డ్యూ టు ద ప్రెజెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆడ్ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ విచ్ ఈస్ అప్లికేబుల్ ఫర్ ఎస్ బ్లాక్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ ఇఫ్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు అప్లై దిస్ పాయింట్ టు డి బ్లాక్ ఎలిమెంట్స్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు సర్చ్ ఫర్ అన్పేర్డ్ డి ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ అన్పేర్డ్ డి ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఇస్ సెట్ టు బి పారామాగ్నెటిక్ అన్పేర్డ్ డి ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఆర్ ఆడ్ నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ ఎలక్ట్రాన్స్ ఇస్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ సో అకార్డింగ్ టు దట్ ఆప్షన్స్ ఫోర్త్ ఆప్షన్ ఈస్ రైట్ ఫర్ ద క్వశ్చన్ పొటాషియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ పొటాషియం సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్ ఈస్ అ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ సబ్స్టెన్స్ అండ్ కలర్ కాంపౌండ్ ఆల్సో అండ్ కలర్డ్ పారామాగ్నెటిక్ యాజ్ వెల్ ఎస్ కలర్డ్ అండ్ నెక్స్ట్ A and B is strongly heated in air. Both of them give oxide, but only B gives nitride. A and B respectively. So, this is also a concept-oriented question. Anomalous behavior of lithium. Anomalous behavior of lithium due to the small in size of lithium. Electronegativity is more. Ionization enthalpy is more. Size is small. Absence of vacant d electrons. This lithium atom is differs with respect to the other elements. What are the differences means lithium metal is hard. Remaining elements all are soft. Lithium carbonate is unstable. Remaining all carbonates are stable. Lithium nitrate also unstable. Lithium nitrate also unstable means that is anomalous behavior property was there. And lithium reacts with oxygen to form monoxide. పొటాషియం రుబీడియం సీజియం ఫామ్ సూపర్ ఆక్సైడ్స్ సోడియం ఫామ్ పెరాక్సైడ్ అండ్ లిథియం డైరెక్ట్లీ కంబైన్డ్ విత్ నైట్రోజన్ టు ఫామ్ నైట్రైడ్ నో అదర్ ఆల్కలీ మెటల్స్ డస్ నాట్ డైరెక్ట్లీ కంబైన్ విత్ నైట్రోజన్ దట్ వాస్ ద పాయింట్ ఎక్సెప్ట్ లిథియం రిమైనింగ్ ఆల్ ఆల్కలీ మెటల్స్ నాట్ డైరెక్ట్లీ కంబైన్ విత్ నైట్రోజన్ ఓన్లీ లిథియం డైరెక్ట్లీ కంబైన్ విత్ నైట్రోజన్ టు ఫామ్ నైట్రైడ్ యాజ్ వెల్ ఎస్ ఆక్సైడ్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ air contains 21% oxygen remaining is nitrogen is 1% of noble gases, different type of gases are there. So that Li plus oxygen gives rise to Li2O. Li2O is called as lithium monoxide. Li2O is called as what it is? Lithium monoxide, 4Li, 2Li2O. Same Li is reacted with N2, gives rise to Li3N. Li3N means lithium nitride. Lithium has the only the capacity to formation of direct nitride. Lithium is a diagonal relation with magnesium. Magnesium also directly produces nitride with nitrogen, oxide with oxygen, because diagonal relationship due to the same in size and same electronegativity and ionic charge. Clear? So lithium gives monoxide with oxygen, nitride with nitrogen. What about potassium? When potassium reacts with oxygen to form potassium superoxide. Potassium reacts with nitrogen, no reaction. Here no reaction. Potassium not reacts with nitrogen. Only lithium can react with nitrogen. So what is A? A is potassium and B is lithium. A is potassium and B is lithium. So option number 4. Option number 4 is the right answer for the question number 44. So 44, option 4. Next, the correct order of hydration energy of alkaline earth metals, metal ions is? The correct order of hydration energy of alkaline earth metal ions. So here, beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium. That only the right order, because of remaining, once you observe the orders, beryllium, radium, calcium, magnesium, strontium, magnesium, beryllium, barium, calcium, strontium. And of the above, what the options they select, it was not satisfied options with respect to the first option. Hydration energy, size small, more hydration energy. Size is large, hydration energy is less. So what the relation between hydration energy versus size means, as atomic size increases, alkali earth metal ions hydration energy decreases. That was the point. You should make a note, my dear students, it is size proportional delta H hydration, enthalpy of hydration it is. Size proportional enthalpy of hydration. Small size, large enthalpy of hydration. Large size, small enthalpy of hydration. From beryllium to barium, size increases. Size increase means enthalpy of hydration decreases. Which is more enthalpy of hydration? Beryllium enthalpy of hydration is more. Barium enthalpy of hydration is least. So what will be the answer? Be2 plus greater than, Mg2 plus greater than, Ca2 plus greater than, Sr2 plus greater than, Ba2 plus. This point you should keep in your mind, size directly proportional to 1 by enthalpy of hydration. According to that only we will get the answer. So answer number 1 is the right option for the question number 48. Next, on dissolving moderate amount of sodium metal in liquid ammonia at low temperature, which one of the following does not occur? So this is also a concept oriented question, very interesting and important question it is. On dissolving moderate amount of sodium metal in liquid ammonia, M plus X plus 4NH3. Gives rise to MnH3 taken X plus electron NH3 taken Y. This particular equation was there in your textbook. M plus X plus 4NH3 gives rise to MnH3 taken X plus electron NH3 taken Y. One is a plus and second one is a minus. So it is a related with alkali metals. When ammonia is treated with sodium metal, liquid ammonia sodium metal reaction at low temperature, we will get this is due to the presence of ammoniated electrons. It is a paramagnetic substance. It is a blue color substance. It is a good conductor of electricity. It is a good conductor of electricity. And this one is one of the property of alkali metals. So on dissolving sodium metal in liquid ammonia, we will get a compound is ammoniated electron takes place. Ammoniated electron takes place. It is a paramagnetic, and it appears in its color, blue color, and it is good conductor of electricity. And this example, we will get Na plus ions. So once you go that concept oriented question, the option number one is the right option. Blue color solution is obtained. Na plus ions are formed in the solution, right? And third one, liquid ammonia became a good conductor of electricity, okay? And liquid ammonia remains diamagnetic. That is wrong option, because that is a paramagnetic substance, not diamagnetic, paramagnetic substance. Instead of dia, they was given paramagnetic. Clear? So this was a fourth option is a wrong statement regarding that. So this will be the end of the session, and on next session we will discuss some more questions regarding S-block elements. I hope you understood. All the best. Thank you.